Star Wars The Force Awakens is amazing. You must be very pleased with it.
Yes, I am very pleased. I'm very pleased with it. I like that it sort of almost implies that in some way I'm responsible for it rather than the millions of experts that have put this incredible thing together.
You are. You're part of an amazing thing, though.
I am.
You must
part
be chuffed.
Of it. I really am chuffed, actually, particularly since I really wanted to be in the Star Wars film. I'd campaigned for 6 months, just desperately asking if I could be seen.
In what format was the asking? Handwritten letters?
I asked my representation repeatedly, can I please be seen?
Yeah.
And then I think I wore some people down, and then I was seen.
Ground them down, one by one.
And then the most bizarre thing of all happened, which was that I was cast in the film.
That's amazing, though.
It is amazing.
So you're a proper fan. We'll get onto that in a second, though. But was there pressure? Because... let's be honest, cards on the table here, Gwendolyn. The prequels were the worst films in the world, the first
Lord.
Three. They were, and it was. I think people were a bit nervous.
Well,
and
I
hoping...
think that's your opinion, dear.
What do you think of the prequels?
I like them. I think they have their place. My personal favourite is, I can't help but love A New Hope, the first, episode 4, 5, and 6. But then I saw A New Hope when I was 6 years old.
Yeah.
So those films I grew up with, and they're very much woven into my early memories, my treasured early memories.
Yeah.
And then I was obviously older when I saw the next set of films. So unfortunately, nothing's ever going to compare to that first taste of Star Wars that you get. But it could be different for different generations.
That's true. But how do you feel within yourself when I say Jar Jar Binks?
Fine.
You're fine with that. That's cool. This
How
is
do
good.
You feel?
It makes me a little bit angry. I don't know.
Really?
Why. Yeah, they're a bit angry, a bit
angry?
Fighty. Not well. I don't know. He was quite annoying though.
Angry's
Judge.
A lot.
That actually, can I downgrade? It makes me feel sad. It makes me feel just a bit sad.
Okay. Well, it's your experience. You have ownership over that.
But it must be an honour to be in a Star Wars movie. Now you got a main role, which was great. But I think there's quite a lot of people who tried to get into the film by any means possible. I was studying the credits. It was Simon Pegg? In the background there.
He's not in the background.
What's he do?
As far as I'm aware... Oh, is this a spoiler? As far as I'm aware, Simon Pegg is in the film.
But somewhere.
In a capacity.
That's the best review he's ever had in his career.
Yeah, isn't that great?
Is Daniel Craig in it? Because I interviewed him for the Bond film and I suggested that he might be a stormtrooper in it, and he went all coy.
Did he go weird?
It went a bit weird on me, yeah.
I can't confirm or deny that because I don't know.
So you don't know whether he was in there in the background or not?
No. I mean, not. I couldn't swear blind, no.
Which brings us on to secrecy that surrounds the film. Very secretive. I love the weird things that you have to do. Did you have to do any strange stuff in the lead-up to this film, like burn scripts or have encryption codes and stuff like that?
No.
No? Thanks
no,
so
I don't
much.
Think I did actually know. I mean, there was quite an interesting experience in that I had to do something I'd never done before, which was at Pinewood, you would be shut in a room and that's where you learnt your lines. You weren't able to take the script away with you.
Oh, so it was only in your head?
Yes.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's quite cool. But they're just worried about ruining it for people, aren't they?
Yes, but I like that about what they've done with this film. I really do like that they've done that with this film, that... It's trying to, in my opinion, it's trying to capture some of the wonderful surprise that we have at times, like around Christmas when we were kids. We have so little surprises now. We see trailers and you see the whole film.
Yeah.
And the idea of having... Everyone's waited so long to see a Star Wars film. And the idea of having a Star Wars film again, I think you want to be surprised by it, don't you?
And it's worked because I don't really think very much has got out about the film ahead of people seeing it. It's been a success.
They've done an amazing job with it. I really do. But it's a lovely experience when you see it, because obviously no matter what you know about a film, when you've worked on it, nothing prepares you for seeing the final product.
Yeah.
And with this film, my opinion is that I think it's not just a great Star Wars movie, I think it's a great film.
No, it is, it really is. And the main shock of the film for me, and it kind of shows the norm, actually, what we're just used to these days, is that when I saw the silver or chrome stormtrooper in the, the pictures for the movie, I just assumed it was going to be a male in that role. So, obviously, you as Captain Phasma...
Captain Phasma,
that was a bit of a shock. It's different, isn't it? It's not only a female lead villain, but a female lead villain in armour.
Yeah. It shouldn't be shocking, though, should
no,
it?
No, it shouldn't be.
But it
shouldn't
is.
Be. But it is. You're
because
right.
Our culture conventionally has been that we have been used to seeing very conventional depictions of females in our mainstream media. And I love that with the costume of Captain Phasma, it wasn't feminized or sexualized in any way. It was just taken in its pure practical form as armor, because she is a soldier. She is captain of the stormtroopers. And I found that refreshing. And I actually think quite a progressive character.
Absolutely. And I think the film does have some very strong female roles in it anyway, doesn't it?
Yes, it does.
There must be tons of pinch me moments when you're filming Star Wars, though. What were you like when you first saw that armour, stormtrooper armour, your stormtrooper armour? That must have been amazing.
It really was amazing. I had been told about it beforehand, but nothing prepared me for going into that room and seeing it there. That was extraordinary. As I've just said, what I loved about it was that I expected, they'll probably have feminized this in some way. And they hadn't.
No.
And I thought that's just really modern and decent. And the casting has been very diverse, I think. I think it's been more diverse than what many people were expecting for this film. But I think the audience and fans have said that they want to see something that's more representative of their society in their media.
Yeah.
And I do think that's what this Star Wars film has given them.
I'd have been very tempted to try and take something from set. Not necessarily stealing, but just borrow for the long run. Were you tempted to pick up any things as like a memento? A bit of your armour, possibly?
Can you define borrow for the long run?
I think...
that to me sounds like stealing.
It's definitely not stealing.
It sounds like theft.
Well, you might bring it back for the next movie. Think, like, you know, say they caught you taking Captain Phasma's...
I feel very unsure about you now.
Well, if you weren't worrying if I'm going to steal from you this afternoon, it's no problem. But I would definitely have nicked stuff, Gwendolyn. No two ways about it.
Would you really?
100%.
Oh, no.
I would have done.
Well, I'm not here.
Did you nick anything? Let's just be...
No.
Were you tempted to take like a...
No, all right, because I'm respectful.
Okay, well, I feel really bad now. Terrible. She's so nicked something.
She nicked nothing.
So what's next then? Because the film sets things up. You know, we kind of get introduced to your character and you can tell that, you know, there's more to it than this. The story's going to continue. It wasn't one of those Lord of the Rings things where you filmed a load of scenes for the next movie ahead in one go. You're going to all meet up back together again and film again soon. What's the plans for the future?
I have absolutely no idea what it is that I can say regarding that.
Yeah.
No idea.
Can't give us a little hint?
Not quite genuinely, not even I know at this stage.
That's fair enough. Well, you won't admit to stealing stuff, so I didn't expect to get any information.
I won't admit, just statement of fact.
Okay. And one other thing, The Force Awakens is a brilliant mix between, I would say, it's a love letter to the old Star Wars films, but also introduces a new generation to the future. My little girl's 5, and I'm very excited that she's going to have this great film as the kind of launch pad for her to get into Star Wars, whether she likes it or not. What are the old guard like? What's like, you know, I'm going to call them by their film names, because if I met them in the street, I would call Harrison Ford Han Solo. What are Han Solo and Princess Leia and all that like to be on set with?
They're thoroughly nice. They are thoroughly nice. And I found it really exciting that they were as excited about the experience as I was, that they all seemed very happy to be doing this film and really happy to be back. And that's a very solidifying experience to have, because you always learn from the top down in those sort of situations. And they were so enthusiastic about it and passionate about the work that it was a real pleasure. But all the crew, everyone there was just so excited to be working on a Star Wars film.
An amazing team. Team spirit and stuff.
Every single day, people were really invigorated to be there and so enthusiastic. There was a lot of... childlike joy about the whole thing.
Well, listen, it's an amazing film. I can't urge people enough to go and see it, because it's as good as I hoped it was and more. So, Gwendoline Christie, thank you so much for coming into Absolute Radio.
Thank you.